Hi, fellow CoCoRaHS observers. Do you love monitoring the weather and precipitation in your area as much as I do? Ever wonder if there is more you can do as a CoCoRaHS observer to share how the precipitation you measure affects you and your community? Well, now you can. As a CoCoRaHS observer, you collect and report daily data that gives scientists and other organizations an idea of how much precipitation has fallen in your area. But what does the amount of precipitation mean for your area? What does it look like? Scientists and managers are interested to know, and you can tell them by submitting a condition monitoring report. A condition monitoring report tells us how precipitation or lack of precipitation is affecting your local environment and community. Unlike daily precipitation reports, condition monitoring reports are submitted weekly to monitor the cumulative effects of precipitation or lack thereof. Condition monitoring reports allow observers to help establish a baseline of information to compare when weather begins to change, including insights into the beginning and ending of droughts. Drought may appear very differently around the United States. Drought in the deserts of Nevada will not look the same as drought in the forests of the Carolinas. Current precipitation data and trends and local conditions can serve as drought early warning systems and help decision makers plan for drought impacts. CoCoRaHS condition monitoring reports are used across the country. The data on the website is accessed by U.S. Drought Monitor Committees, the National Weather Service, weather and climate scientists, farmers, teachers, city workers, and countless other individuals and organizations. For example, drought committees can read the condition monitoring reports and see if they need to change the drought status of an area based on the amount of precipitation and how the environment is responding. Your local knowledge of conditions included in your reports helps with assessing the precipitation data. By submitting regular condition monitoring reports, it becomes easier to see how dry seasons differ from wet seasons. These reports also enable us to know what conditions to expect every year to determine long-term effects of drought. To submit a condition monitoring report, simply click on the link to the left of your daily precipitation report form. The first part of the condition monitoring report is the condition scale bar. The condition scale bar lets you choose from 7 categories ranging from severely dry to severely wet to indicate how current conditions compare to what is normal for the current time of year. Your local knowledge of the community and the environment where you live makes you an expert in describing the impacts of precipitation you have measured. Don't worry if at first you aren't confident about what to select. Do your best and you'll quickly become more in tune with your conditions as each week progresses. If you haven't received either more or less precipitation than what you might expect for that time of year, check near normal. Just like reporting zeros on days when there is no rain, it is important to record when conditions in your area are normal. Conditions might be mildly wet if recent precipitation levels have been a little above normal, local plants, crops, or pastures are healthy, and soils are a little wetter than usual. Moderately wet conditions may be represented by standing water in low areas and ditches, water bodies that are slightly more full than normal, and partially saturated soils. You might opt for the severely wet scale bar selection if water levels are very elevated, if there has been flooding that has led to plant or crop damage, if standing water is severe and abundant, and the ground is completely saturated with water. It may only be mildly dry if you have noticed that growth may have slowed for plants, crops, or pastures, the soil is a little dry, or that precipitation levels have been below normal for a period of time. Moderately dry conditions include when plants may be brown due to dry conditions, voluntary water use restrictions are in place, streams, reservoirs, or well water levels may be low, and soil is dry. You might select the severely dry option if ponds, lakes, streams, and wells are nearly empty or dry, mandatory water restrictions are in place or water shortages are present, soil moisture is absent, or crops have failed. By selecting one of these conditions, you are giving managers and scientists a quick insight into what precipitation levels are in your area relative to normal conditions. Over time, your scale bar selections will help show how conditions may have transitioned from wet to dry or dry to wet, depending on the season and how much precipitation has fallen. Don't worry if you select the same scale bar category for several weeks in a row. Environmental conditions usually change slowly over time unless there is an extreme event such as a blizzard or a hurricane. The next part of your report will be a brief description of what you have observed in your area. Describe how dry, normal, or wet conditions are affecting you, your livelihood, or your activities. If you have planted a garden and noticed that the plants are wilting and turning brown, report it. If you have fire restrictions in your area, Report it. If there are trails closed due to flooding at your local park, report it. If your ski trip was canceled because the snowpack is low, report it. Check out reports from your fellow observers to get new ideas for information to include in your own reports. The final section of the condition monitoring report asks you to check any category you reported in your description. If you reported on the water levels of the lake where you kayak, check the water supply and quality and tourism and recreation categories. If you reported on local crop conditions or how you've been watering your yard or garden, check the agriculture category. If pollen levels are high and you haven't had any recent rain to wash it away, check the society and public health category. Gesundheit! When you are writing your report, you can use the categories to guide your written descriptions of current conditions as well. You can view condition monitoring reports from CoCoRaHS all over the country on the national web map found here. The web map provides access to all condition monitoring reports and lets observers see others' reports and learn about conditions in other parts of their state, region, or country. Who can submit a condition monitoring report? Anyone who is already a CoCoRaHS observer. All current observers are able to submit condition monitoring reports through the CoCoRaHS website. Are you interested in becoming a new CoCoRaHS observer? For more information on becoming a condition monitoring volunteer, sign up on the CoCoRaHS website at www.cocoraHS.org.